We've seen how expensive it would be to track all the photons in a scene. To avoid this level of computation, in computer graphics we make a number of simplifying assumptions. First, only those photons that reach the camera are the ones needed to make the image. So, these are the only ones we would like to compute. We know which objects we can see, but how do we know in advance which photons will matter? Each photon is generated by a light source, but we don't know where each ends up. So, we reverse the process. Instead of sending photons from the light, we essentially cast a ray from the eye through each pixel and see what's out there. When a surface is seen at a pixel, we then compute the direct effect of each light on that surface. Add up all the light contributions and you have a reasonable approximation of what the surface looks like. One more approximation can be used for these lights. Nothing blocks them. Every surface is considered visible to a light unless it faces away from that light source. In other words, no objects cast shadows. This simplification saves us a lot of computation. Rendering can get even simpler than this. For example, you could do away with lights altogether and just draw each object with a solid color. However, I'm drawing the line there, as lights add considerable realism and perception of 3D to a scene. For example, look at this scene with and without lights. So there are two extremes. At one end, photons are carefully traced from light emitters through a scene, potentially giving a highly realistic image. At the other end, the camera determines what gets viewed and a rough approximation of what light reaches each surface is determined. This process can be unrealistic, but can be computed extremely fast. We'll start with this second extreme and in later lessons show how we can remove or modify various simplifications so that more photon-based computations are performed, such as casting shadows.